Good evening to everyone here. My name is Chris Curie, spelled Q-U-I-R-A-Y. And I was born and raised in Burrillville, and I currently reside in Webster, Massachusetts, which is the little green one up there in the top left corner, because we would very much be affected by the location of this. I fall right into the air pollution zone, even up there in Massachusetts. But in my professional capacity, I work in the solar industry and finding and proving locations to site systems. We're held to strict regulations and permitting processes. If I tried to file an incomplete application for a permit, it would be rejected. It is also within my job duties to deny some proposed sites if I deem they would not comply with local and state regulations. It is evident that the application for the proposed power plant should be rejected on a number of factors not limited to unacceptable environmental harm, a complete lack of transparency, insufficient proof that the energy is needed, overwhelming public opposition, and the fact that we have access to superior technology to meet our energy needs. So I know that you've all heard an awful lot about how we need to ditch fossil fuels and embrace renewable energy sources. Sometimes when you hear the same thing over and over, it tends to dull the message. Well, I'm telling you right now, loud and clear as I can, we have every reason to stop new fossil fuel projects. We should be tripling down on solar and wind installations. You know, in comparing the two, I'd like to speak briefly about something called externalities. What are externalities? You know, one of the most common examples is pollution emitted from a factory or a power plant that spoils the surrounding environment and affects the health of the nearby residents. This is a negative externality. And looking at this project, the negative externalities seem off the charts. I mean, we're talking about drilling and fracking for the fuel, land impact from pipeline construction and eventual pipeline leaks, because that's what they do, reckless overuse of public water supplies, the trucks, the clear cutting of forests, and the list goes on. So this is just dirty, outdated technology. Did you know that National Grid actually wants to clear cut over 70 acres just to put a transmission line running from the proposed site to overstate power? Now, I told you we have superior technology. We're well positioned as a state to harness wind power from the coast. Solar power, for the same amount of space that you would need to clear cut just for the transmission line there. You know, solar panels could power well over 2,000 homes. Enough for roughly all homes in Pasco and Harrisville. It would be generating and distributing the power, mind you. The real kicker, though, is that you would never have to clear that land or dig up that fuel. We could put the panels on rooftops and on already cleared land. We could put them right on top of this school and be generating and distributing the power locally and cleanly. Rhode Island is a unique place in that we have a small infrastructure and an ample amount of coastline. We could feasibly make a rapid transition to renewable energies and become a leading state in the nation when it comes to modernizing our electric grid, and I really truly believe that. What we need is real leadership in this state, and I am asking you to be some of those leaders and reject this god-awful project. Thank you.